Hello, I'm Princess Sally Acorn. We will learn about political systems. A political system defines the process for making official government decisions. It is usually compared to the legal system, economic system, cultural system, and other social systems. Now we go ahead and find out the types in anthropological form. Uncentralized systems, centralized governments, supranational political systems, empires, and leagues. Let's start with uncentralized systems. Also called decentralized systems, political decentralization signifies reduction in the authority of national governments over policymaking. A national government decides to decentralize its authority and responsibilities for a variety of reasons. Its goals are dependent on its participation, diversity, efficiency, and conflict resolution. Next, the centralized governments, also called centralized system, in which power or legal is exerted are coordinated by a political executive to which federal states, local authorities, and smaller units are considered subject. Next, a supranational union is a type of multinational political union where negotiated power is delegated to an authority by governments of member states. The term supranational is sometimes used in a loose, undefined sense in other contexts, such as a substitute for international, transnational, or global. And describe the European Union, on the other hand, as a new type of political entity. It is the only entity that provides for international popular elections, going beyond the level of political integration normally afforded by international treaties. Next. Empire. An empire is a sovereign state functioning as an aggregate of nations or people that are ruled over by an emperor or another kind of monarch. Let us now consider a map view for Roman Empire. Back in the ancient times, 117 AD, the territory and population of an empire is commonly of greater extent than the one of a kingdom, such as Austro-Hungarian Empire or the Russian Empire, or of territories far remote from the homeland, such as a colonial empire. And finally, leagues. Leagues are international organizations composed of states coming together for a single common purpose. In this way, leagues are different from empires, as they only seek to fulfill a single goal. Often leagues are formed on the brink of a military or economic downfall. This was the anthropological form of political system. In the next part, we'll tell you about the sociology of political system. Like, comment, and subscribe now.